What is up, everyone? PureChaosX here with part 8 of the Grasshopper restoration video, and I've got a few more parts for it to help make it look and eventually drive better. Yes, it's been a few weeks collecting these, and at the moment they're all in this box. So just to keep them in, you know, one place. I painted my Mad Bull in a lavender colour from Tamiya. I think that looks quite nice. I was having an idea. I don't like the Mad Bull that much, mostly because of how it drives, because of the big wheels and tyres. Seems to be too big for that. What I was thinking of doing was getting these wheels on there, which they do fit, and then getting the same Schumacher tyres that are on my Acro Shot on those on there. I think that'll work. I think it'll look quite good as well. And they're slightly smaller, slightly thinner, so I think it might handle a bit better. But I need to give that a go. Thankfully, they're not too expensive, so I might do that. Especially if the tyres that I've got for this don't really fit properly. So it's a bit dark. It's very dark. It's raining all morning. Well, I bought a new body to replace that. That was just kind of like a basher body, and I just wanted to see how well I could restore it. So I bought a new body shell and some stickers. So it's going to look like a grasshopper. So, you know, the way it's supposed to look. And there will be a driver figure in there as well. So, So there's going to be a new body with some proper decals. So that way it'll look like a grasshopper should. I also bought some black, a pot of black paint to do the little extra details, such as the bars here and this bit at the back. That also needs to be black. So I can mask those off and paint them with this. I also bought the Tamiya's premium or more expensive paintbrushes. So yeah, tell me do that, because I don't really have any paintbrushes like that. So that'll help. And yeah, a little pot of paint to do the little extra details there. just a few little cosmetic things as well. Some green wheel nuts and a green aluminium heatsink to take cover over that motor cover. Now, unfortunately, they did send me the wrong one. Let me get it out of the packet. I mean, the color's correct, but it says Hornet. I mean, they did give me the option to send it back, but I thought, well, you know what? It looks nice. It looks nice enough that I'd like to keep it. So I did. And you won't really be able to see that anyway, unless you're really looking. So I thought that might be quite interesting. So just, again, a little bit of a cosmetic thing, just to go with the green of the decals. So I think that'll, you know, that'll kind of go quite well. The light pods from the comical chassis and some LEDs. These were not wired up. I had to wire these up to a connector. As this was more of an LED kit, the LEDs were pre-wired, and it came with a switch, a 9-volt battery connector, and 4 LED holders. But I'm only going to put 2 in the front on the light pods. I was thinking about putting some red ones, because it came with 2 red ones as well, in the rear. But I didn't really know where to put the light pods, because there's nowhere really on the back to sort of screw them on. Plus, I didn't really want to solder 4 wires. Well, no, 8 wires, technically. Yeah. My cat wants to come into my room. So, give me 2 seconds. So, yeah, I was going to put some rear ones on. I don't know. I don't really want to rewire that. And I don't want to make 2 sets of these with another connector to to take up two slots on the receiver. So we'll see. But yeah, that's the number, or the part number, if you want to know. So yeah. And also, I've realized that this actually fits on the Kong head chassis. So I might actually get this bumper for the Kong head and maybe get another set of light pods. That might be interesting. What's it what? So yeah. So some lights. And now I might have gone a bit overboard with the tires. Like I said, they are Blitzer Beetle tires, which do fit on there. These are the front ones. These definitely might not fit with the bumper on. So yeah, this might be a little bit excessive. And the rear ones. I mean, it's really the rear ones I want, because, you know, it's rear wheel drive, so I wanted the rear ones for the grip. So I'll see how these ones, the front ones, fit. If these are a bit poo, because I still need to get a faster motor. I'm still not happy with how slow that 21 turn motor is with the gearing, so I want to get a faster motor for it. So yeah, we'll see how these run. But yeah, I think it's definitely the front ones might not fit with that bumper on because of these bits. In fact, it looks like it might be kind of close, even when they're not even steering. I mean, you know, it's kind of close. So yeah, that's. But yeah, we'll see what the front ones are like, and we'll see what the back ones are like. If it's kind of a bit meh, I don't know, I might actually put these tires and those wheels on the Mad Bull to see what that looks like, and then put the Grasshopper away somewhere until I can get some original wheels and tires for it, and we'll go from there. That way it'll actually look like a proper Grasshopper rather than whatever this is going to be. So but yeah, this doesn't look as white as I thought it was going to be. It does look a lot more, I don't think it's gone yellow in the sun, but it just isn't as white as I thought it would be. So, especially when you can compare it to the white wheels. But, oh well, it is what it is. Anyway, I'm going to get on and do this as well first, maybe. Put the stickers on, get the tires on, get these all hooked up, and then obviously do the painting last, probably. So, yeah, there we go. That's part 8, I think. For new parts for the Grasshopper. So, I'm still undecided as to whether or not to sell this on eBay or not. One of the things that happens when you restore something and you kind of put your own personal touch to it, you don't want to sell it. It's your own personal touch. You know, you've made it yours, kind of thing. So, yeah. Well, you know, I could just keep these wheels on and these tires and sell it and just get another set of Acro Shot tires for these and stick them on there, because like I said, they will fit, and it might help the Mad Bull handle a bit better, especially in reverse. It might have that annoying wobble as it goes blah 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 blah. So yeah, if I remember at the end of this video, if I haven't uploaded it yet, I'll put in some shots of what this looks like after everything's done. Obviously, I want to get this video uploaded as soon as possible, but I'll wait as long as I can while I get everything obviously done. So yeah, and then I'll take a few photos of it. And if anyone does want to buy it, UK only, let me know. I just do not know. It's not a car I'm going to run a lot, because it is, you know, what would you call it? A beginner's buggy. You know, like the Hornet and the Rising Fighter. It's for entry-level drivers, I would say, because it's very simple and easy. So it isn't something I would actually run ever, probably. Maybe every now and again, just to keep things moving, like keep the motor moving and whatnot. But it's not saying I'm going to take out as much as I would that, or Mutti DO2 kind of thing. So, if anyone is interested in purchasing it in the UK, I will, and I'll also, I'll replace the transmitter that's in there with a core RC transmitter and receiver that I've currently got. It's that steer wheel from Core RC. So I'll replace it with that. So I'll sell it with the transmitter and receiver, just not the receiver that's in there now, because I'll keep that from one of my other cars. So if you, anyone is interested in buying this after it's done, let me know. Or whether or not you'd like to keep those wheels, or whether you'd want these tires or whatnot. So yeah, we'll go from there. Anyway, I'm going to start doing some stuff. So yeah, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. I don't know if there's going to be a part 9. The part 9 might be the end result if I forget to put some photos at the end of this one. So yeah, keep an eye out for that. I suppose we're going to be nearly done. Yeah. See you in whatever part whatever part is next, like part 9 or maybe not. We'll see. So yeah, thank you for watching. Bye.